Good morning, students. Today we'll study the 12th chapter of your EVS book, Changing Times. In this chapter, we'll study the story of Chetan Das, who was a teacher, but now he is writing his old memories and sharing some of his memories with us. Students, Chetan Das family lived in Dera Ghazi Khan. This place now is in Pakistan. Our neighbor country, Pakistan, was once a part of India, and it was only after the independence, 1947, that Pakistan and Bangladesh, they became a separate country and shifted to become another nation. I am showing you map before independence. You can see Bangladesh and Pakistan was once part of India. After the independence, Bangladesh and Pakistan, they were separated from India. And many people had to move from India to Pakistan and from Pakistan to India. In this picture, you can see people shifting from their original place and going to settle down in some new place. Similarly, Chetan Das is saying they had to shift from, because Dera Ghazi Khan was part of Pakistan, and they have to shift to India. Before settling, they stayed in a camp, and they were lived in a camp made of big tents. See in the pictures, these were the tents laid for the migratory people. After some time, they got a land near Sohna village, and their parents, they built a house in that village, and unbaked bricks were used for making it, and their mother, they coated the floor of the house with the cow dung. Roof was made by joining the strips of wood, and they also put some branches of neem and kikar, and Amma put old gunny bag on this and covered them with mud. So this was the way they made their house in Sohna village. Now he is saying time quickly passed, and before my marriage I also wanted to build one more room, and at now they use iron and cement for making the roof of the house. In those days, unbaked bricks were also available in the market. We made the wall with them. Now you can see the changes in the construction of the house. These are unbaked bricks. They also had a small kitchen in the courtyard. And in the kitchen there was a mud chula. Now he is saying my two sons and a daughter were born in that house. The children completed their studies, and their daughter also got married. And now it was the turn of the Raju to get married, but they need one more room and to renovate their house for the new bride. This time they use baked brick. As you can see in the picture, these are baked bricks, and now you can see the changes. Cement and iron is used, and floor is also made of marble chips. Kitchen was made bigger because Raju's wife does not want to use the clay chula. They also made a modern toilet. He is saying that his younger son want to move to Delhi. When he got a job there, they are now staying with Raju sometime and sometime with Montu. And this type of building they used to see in Delhi and Gurgaon. He is saying, now I am 70 year old. All these years I have seen many changes. See, this was the house in Dera Ghazi Khan, and now they are seeing this type of houses, as their younger son is staying in this type of high-rising building, and they are having apartment. there. Let's see changes in the Chetan Das house. First of all, mud house that was in the Sohna village. It was made with the mud, husk, wood, straw, cow dung, neem and kikar leaves. Then they built one room and kitchen built with unbaked bricks, mud chula, small toilet behind the house. House renovated during Raju's marriage. They used baked bread, brick, lintel in the roof, cement and marble chips flooring, flushable toilets and gas stove for cooking. Students, now there is a question for you. Over the 60 years, different materials were used in the different times in Chetan Das house. List them in the correct order. So this was all from this chapter. Stay safe. Thank you.